Okay, it's recording. What's up, everybody? I'm gonna try to do something a little new. Not exactly a new concept, but it's new to me. I've said every year, during almost every major award show, that I was going to make a video reacting to the winners. I mean, not a live reaction, but you know, I saw the award show. I have the list of winners in front of me, and I was going to give my reaction to the winners. I've always said I was going to do that particular type of video. Why? I don't know. I like attention, you know? I like views, even though I only get 10 of them. Okay, so anyway, the Emmys of 2016, the 68th Annual Emmy Awards have finished. They've wrapped, they've aired, even though technically right now they are re-airing on ABC. Jimmy Kimmel, sorry, there's more than one Jimmy, so I get confused. Jimmy Kimmel was the host, he was terrific. It was a really fun show. I think he deserves major props for hosting. He did a really fantastic and funny job. And overall, it was a pretty funny show. I'm not here to review the actual show. I'm just here to read off the winners and give my opinions towards them. It's kind of something I've always wanted to do. I don't know why. I've always wanted to do it, but yet I put it off. I never do it. Well, I'm going to attempt to do that with the Emmys. So, the Emmys, if you watched it, let me know what you thought of the show. And if you didn't watch it, you know that it was over 3 hours. Therefore, I don't want to make a 3-hour video. So, I'm going to try to make this quick, as quick as I can. Okay, and I know saying that, I usually hex myself. I usually curse myself by saying that because I end up making a long video regardless. But I'm going to go ahead. What I'm going to do is I'm going to read the list from the bottom up. So I'm going off of the Yahoo winners list. I will leave a link in the description to give you the full details, the full list of winners, because I'm not going to read them all. I'm not going to read every nomination, I should say. I'm just going to read off the winners and give my thoughts. So here we go at what? Yay, under 3 minutes. Okay, let's go ahead and get to it. And some of these categories, I don't have a whole lot to say, so don't worry about that. I'll make it quick. For Outstanding Director for a Variety Special, the winner went to, I'm not really going to say the names, unless they're really relevant. The winner went to Grease Live. Why? most people who know me know that I am not a fan of Grease, like, at all, basically. But even with that said, I was curious, so I did watch a little bit of that special, and it sucked. It sucked. I thought it was a really crappy production. I understand if people liked it, but to award that, but not award the person who directed Adele's special in New York, or even all the collaborators of Lemonade, the Beyonce HBO special, which is very artsy and very creative. I don't see it. I think that Grease Live was crap, to be honest. But that's just my opinion. For Outstanding Director for a Limited Series, Movie or Dramatic Special. Now, this category was almost dominated by the People versus O.J. Simpson, American Crime Story. There were 3 episodes nominated in this category, and there was also a Fargo episode, and for something called All the Way, which I have no idea what that is. The winner ended up being Susan Blair for The Night Manager. Again, I have no idea what that is, but I do know that it has Tom Hiddleston, so it must be good. There you go. But regardless, it was pretty interesting that we had 3 episodes of the OJ series, mini series, and none of them could win. And one of them was directed by John Singleton, who I think is very, I've always been a fan of John Singleton. For Outstanding Director in a Comedy Series, we had two episodes of Silicon Valley nominated. We had three other episodes nominated. Damn, that's like, what, seven nominations? Three episodes for Veep. That show just will not go away. But the winner ended up being for Transparent. For the episode Man on the Land. I've never seen that show. I've never seen any of these shows. I definitely want to see Master of None and Silicon Valley. I guess I have to see Veep since it wins everything. I don't really have a whole lot of interest in Transparent though. Maybe one day I'll get around to watching it, but I'm not really, it's not on my agenda. But congrats to the winner, Jill Soloway. She seemed like a very humble winner, and I can tell that this was a very important win for her. So good for her. For Outstanding Directing for a Dramatic Series, the winner, I'm very happy. The winner went to Miguel Sapochnik. He won for the great, amazing episode of Game of Thrones entitled Battle of the Bastards. Thank goodness. That's one of the greatest things ever directed for a TV show ever. That is amazing. That is a cinematic experience in an hour-long show on TV, even though it's HBO. Still, what was done in that episode was phenomenal. So I'm very, very happy it won. The other nominations were very good. We had the Door episode from Game of Thrones and, you know, Downton Abbey and all these other shows that I haven't seen yet. But I'm sure they're all great in their own right, but I'm very happy for Battle of the Bastards winning. For Outstanding Writing in a Variety Show, this I have zero interest in, but what the hell. They gave it to Patton Oswalt for Talking for Clapping, which was very cool because you could tell he was very shocked and surprised. And good for him, you know. I think Patton Oswalt was a funny comedian. And then, you know, he recently lost his wife. So this definitely makes it feel, I'm sure he feels a whole lot, I'm sure he feels humbled. And this will help him cope with his loss. He dedicated the award to his wife. It was really sweet, even though it was kind of rushed, because, you know, they're trying to rush everybody off the stage. So good for him. I'm just glad that Amy Schumer did not win. Anytime she doesn't win anything, it makes me very happy. The next category is Outstanding Writing for a Limited Series, Movie, or Dramatic Special. The winner, no big surprise. Well, actually, it was a surprise. What am I saying? An episode of the O.J. Simpson show entitled Marsha, Marsha, Marsha. Why did they give it that title? Come on. Directed by D.V. Da Vincentis. That episode won, but there were like two other nominations for that show, for that category, and whatever. I mean, that show nearly dominated tonight. So, if one thing was very apparent in tonight's broadcast of the Emmy Awards, it's the fact that I guess I have to watch The People vs. O.J. Simpson, American Crime Story. I gotta see it, apparently. Everybody loves it. I never had an interest in seeing it because, you know, I kind of saw the real thing happen. But what the hell? I guess I'll see the dramatized version of it, whatever we call it. Let's see. The next category is for outstanding writing for a comedy series. The winner went to Master of None for the episode entitled Parents, written by Aziz Azari and Alan Young. I haven't seen that show yet. I haven't seen any of these other shows yet, but I'm glad that one. I'm glad that Alan Yang, gave the speech that he gave. He basically said that just give Asian actors a chance, and that was cool. I'm glad for both of them, even though it was kind of awkward for Aziz because he didn't get a chance to speak, and when they allowed him to speak, he kind of just rushed off the stage. So I don't know what happened there. But whatever, okay, I want to see that show. Obviously you have Veep nominated a couple of times in Silicon Valley, and then something called Catastrophe, never heard of it. But, okay, Master of None, I intend to see that. Outstanding writing for a drama series was Game of Thrones, Battle of the Bastards. Very happy. I'm happy because I love that episode. But the thing is, I haven't seen any of these other shows. Mr. Robot, I want to see. I kind of want to watch Unreal. My niece says it's really funny and clever. But the thing about Battle of the Bastards is it was a really good show. And it had a good story to it. But I'm pretty sure these other episodes probably had better scripts to it. But hey, I'm not complaining. I love Game of Thrones. I love that episode. So, okay, so outstanding host for reality competition. I really care less. In fact, I don't think they aired this award. RuPaul won for RuPaul's Drag Race. I have no interest in that or any of these shows, to be honest. So let's just move on. For a reality competition series, again, not very interested in, even though I occasionally watch American Ninja Warrior, even though I think they need to drop the warrior unless they add actual fighting to the competition. But the winner was The Voice. I can get behind that. I think that that's kind of a cool show. Every once in a great while, I'll unintentionally tune in, meaning I'm cleaning and washing dishes and somebody's watching it, or it's on the big TV, nobody changed the channel. And I like that, what that show stands for. I'm definitely glad that it wasn't The Amazing Race. I don't know why the hell that show's still on the air. Who the hell watches that? The Outstanding Variety Sketch Series, I went to Key and Peele. Happy about that. I think those two are very funny. And I'm just happy it was not Amy Schumer. Variety Talk Series, that went to John. Let me say the whole title. Last Week Tonight with John Oliver. My niece was very happy. She's a big fan of his, and I think he's really funny and quite brilliant. So I think that's a good win. It was actually a good category. You had James Corden, he's pretty funny. Jimmy Kimmel, that was hysterical. The bit that they did after that category, excuse me. I am so glad that I brought a bottle of water. I wasn't going to, but I'm so glad. But when Jimmy Kimmel lost, Matt Damon came out. Obviously, it was a bit, but it was really funny. And he kind of rubbed it in Janine's face. So I thought that was really cool. Okay, guest actress in a drama series. Again, I guess this is a pointless video for me to be doing, because half this stuff I haven't even seen. My favorite shows do not get award nominations. Not all of them anyway. Why am I doing this, video? The Americans, Margot Mortadelli. She won for being a guest on The Americans. I do want to see that show eventually, but I haven't gotten around to it. Okay. Guest Actress is a comedy series. It went to Tina Fey and Amy Poehler for Saturday Night Live. Yes, absolutely. Because for once in a... I actually saw the episode. And I said to myself, oh my god, this is funny. SNL, for a brief, you know, 90 minutes, is funny. So, absolutely, they deserve the win. And once again, Amy Schumer did not. So, thank you for that. Guest actor in a comedy series went to Peter Scolari for Girls. I've not seen that show. Bob Newhart came out on The Big Bang Theory. Why? Why? Okay, let's just move on. Guest actor in the drama series went to Hank Azaria for Ray Donovan. I really want to see that show, and I like Hank Azaria. I think he's a really good actor, but, you know, I have nothing to really say about this. Outstanding actress in a limited series or movie, Regina King for American Crime. I'm really surprised at that. I'm glad for her. I like Regina King. Regina King, Boondocks, baby. I love Regina King's work in that show. But I know she's a really good actress, and I'm probably not going to watch that series, but I'm glad she won. Good for her. Yeah. It looks like they had some good nominees, though. Okay, Outstanding Supporting Actor in a Limited Series or Movie. It went to a guy named Sterling K. Brown. I honestly don't know who this guy is. I'm sure I've seen him in something, but I don't know who he is. He won for The People vs. O.J. Simpson, American Crime Story. This guy had such a genuine, amazing reaction. I mean, the guy was just in such a daze. Like, it's like his body couldn't move. He gave a pretty gracious speech. I'm glad they gave it to this guy. I like seeing somebody who I don't really know get an award, because it really gets me to say, okay, I need to see this. And he went up against some incredible competition. Though I swear, if my eyes didn't deceive me, and it showed like all the actors lined up, you know, to film their reactions, I swear I could have. I know Joaquin Woodbine, who was nominated for Fargo, it looked like he said, ah, man. It looked like he really wanted to win. Good for this guy. He made a great speech, and I'm telling you, he couldn't even move. I thought he was going to tell Terrence Howard, who presented the award, to carry it on the last stage. So, and good for him. Good to see, somebody who I don't know win. For Outstanding Supporting Actress in a Drama Series, this was kind of funny. It went to Maggie Smith for Downton Abbey. She had won before, and Jimmy Kimmel made a bit, saying that if Maggie Smith wins, or the rule of tonight's Emmys was, if you weren't at the show, you don't get your award. And this is because of Maggie Smith. 3 times she's won, she's never shown up, but he made a bit that, you know, if she wins, she's not going to get the award. So that was really funny. This is where I can actually say something. I'm disappointed because, I mean, she had already won. Is she really that good in the show? I don't know. I'm never going to watch Downton Abbey. But you had 3 really amazing actresses nominated for Game of Thrones. Amelia Clarke, Lena Headey, and Nicey Williams. I was so happy when she got the nomination. Good for her. I wanted Amelia Clarke to win so bad. I wanted Khaleesi, Daenerys, to go up on stage. And even though she would be fully clothed, she would still look empowering. Obviously, I think she would look more empowering. Come on, that scene in Game of Thrones was incredible. I wanted her to win. I would have been happy with any of the actresses from Game of Thrones winning. I wouldn't have even been happy for Constance Zimmer to win for Unreal, even though I've never seen it. But I've seen clips of her work. She looks fantastic, and I think that I'm a fan of hers. I think she was great in the show Entourage, and she had some good work in Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. And I would have loved to have seen her win, but it didn't happen. Maggie Smith, damn you. Outstanding Supporting Actor in a Drama Series. This went to Ben Mendelsohn for Bloodline. Another disappointment. I have not seen Bloodline. I want to, although recently it was announced that the show's gonna get canceled from Netflix, of all places. Even my niece was like, Netflix canceled shows? For some reason, the show was costing $7 million per episode. What? They were spending like $70 million per season. Like, what the hell is that about? I wanted Kit Harington to win for Game of Thrones. I think he played... His best work ever was in the first three episodes. You've seen the show, you know what I'm talking about. And you also know I'm making a joke. But no, I wanted to see him win, because Peter Dinklage already won, which he looked outstanding too. His beard was awesome. I'm jealous. I'm getting there though. But I wanted Kit Harington to win. Harington, what did I call him? And I kind of wanted John Voight to win. I thought John Voight never wins anything. But I'm pretty sure he's an Oscar winner. Oh well. Okay, so next is Outstanding Supporting Actress in a Comedy. It went to Kate McKinnon for Saturday Night Live. Good for her. Like, seriously, good for her. I mean, she's going up against all these other shows that are on cable or the internet, with the exception of Allison Jenny with the CBS show Mom. But she won for Saturday Night Live of all shows, and that's good because she's basically the only good person, the only funny person other than Jay Farrell, which he's leaving now, so that show's dead. She won, she's funny, she deserves it, and I loved her reaction. She wanted to cry, she was crying, she couldn't believe it. She was so overcome with joy, and I think that's fantastic. She's a very funny lady. I've not seen Ghostbusters, and I don't care, but other stuff that she's done, she's really talented, and I'm glad she got acknowledged. She looked really lovely tonight, too. Outstanding Actor in a Comedy was really surprising. It went to Louis Anderson. I can't believe it. I honestly didn't even know that fucker was alive still. Good for him. I mean, he won for playing a mother, I guess. But, he had some incredible competition, dude. I really wanted Titus Burgess to win for Unbreakable Kimmy Schmidt. I love that character. I think he's hilarious. Titus Andromedon. I wanted him to win. I knew he wasn't. I thought it was going to be Tony Hale again. But Louis Anderson, man, good for him. I mean, wow, he's still loud. But good for him. I mean, keep hitting my mic. Good for him. Why not? I'm glad that it went to somebody different, because it could have went to Tony Hale, like I said. For Outstanding Lead Actress in a Limited Series or Movie, Sarah Paulson, The People vs. O.J. Simpson, American Crime Story. She won for playing Marcia Clark. Everybody knew she was going to win. I don't even watch the show, and I knew she was going to win. She apparently deserved it. And yeah, her too. She had outstanding competition. Did anybody catch a glimpse as to how amazing Kirsten Dunst looked? Oh my god. And Kerry Washington. Pregnant? Not pregnant? That woman just, you cannot make Kerry Washington look ugly, ever, or unattractive. Oh my god, she's a goddess. I hate her husband. I hate him. I'm jealous, and I hate him. But yeah, Sarah Paulson, she gave a good speech, even though it was written down. I have a thing against people with, lists and scripts. I really like it when things are spoken from the heart. But hey, she won, she deserved it, I'm sure. And the next category is Outstanding Lead Actor in a Limited Series or Movie. That went to Courtney B. Vance, also for The People vs. OJ. Courtney B. Vance is a very underrated actor, I think. And I'm so happy that he won. He went up against his co-star, Cuba Gooding Jr., which, you know, I'm sure he deserved it as well. I mean, this is amazing. These actors are amazing in this category. Bryan Cranston, Benedict Cumberbatch, Idris Elba, Tom Hiddleston, Cuba Gooding Jr. These are movie stars. But, yeah, Courtney B. Vance, really good actor. I'm glad to see him win something. And I love that he gave this really thunderous thank you speech. And he thanked his beautiful wife, Angela Bassett. I loved what he said. The woman that rocks my chain every day. That was cool. I'm glad. I'm glad he won. He's a really talented actor. Outstanding television movie. Sherlock, The Abominable Bride. That's not necessarily a surprise. I know a lot of people like Sherlock. I like 2 episodes. I've only seen 2 episodes. I feel so bad. I need to see it. I need to go back to it. Actually, I've seen 3 episodes within 3 years. So for all those people who are like, I need Sherlock to come back, I need to catch up to Sherlock, and it's not like there's that many episodes. Cool, I'm glad it won. It did have some really good competition. I don't know why the hell A Very Murray Christmas was nominated. That just was not very good. I love Bill Murray, but I couldn't even finish it. But hey, Sherlock won, good for that. Outstanding Limited Series, no big surprise, and yet another reason why I need to watch this damn thing, The People vs. OJ. I'm not going to say the whole title. Okay, it's too long. The People vs. OJ, it had some really good competition as well. So, again, it's not a surprise. But I've got to see that damn show. Outstanding Lead Actress in a Comedy Series. Once again, Julia Louis-Dreyfus for Veep. This show cannot be stopped in the comedy category. If I'm not mistaken, Because this was, everything that won this year, it was the fifth consecutive time that it won. I swear, correct me if I'm wrong, but within a span of a decade, only two shows have ever won for comedy at the Emmys. Modern Family and then Veep. Once Veep came along, Modern Family, you know, they had a long winning streak, but then Veep just, I don't know what's up with this show, man. But I gotta tell you, I love watching Julia Louis-Dreyfus win. Because my gosh, she's still such a beautiful woman. She's incredibly funny. She's always very gracious. She makes me laugh every time she wins. So good for her. I really, really, really wanted Ally Kemper for Unbreakable Kimmy Schmidt to win. I know she'll get it one day. I hope she gets it one day. I want her to win so bad. I love her in that show. I love that show. I would have also been happy if it were Tracy Ellis Ross for Blackish. But I'm very happy once again that Amy Schumer did not win. No, guys, I don't like Amy Schumer. I don't. In case you haven't picked up on that yet. Outstanding lead actor in a comedy series. Once again, it went to Jeffrey Tambor for Transparent. Again, never seen the show. Not exactly interested in seeing it. Just doesn't look like my kind of show. But I love it when he wins too, because he's very gracious and very sweet, and he always has a very positive message. I'm glad he won. I would have loved to have seen Aziz win for Master None, even though I've never seen it. I kind of wanted Anthony Anderson to win for Blackish, because I'm a big fan of that show, but I'm not surprised. So, Jeffrey Tambor, great actor, definitely deserving, I'm sure. So, outstanding lead actress in a drama series. This was an incredible category, because you have Viola Davis, who won last year, I believe. You know, you had Claire Danes, she's always there. But you had Taraji P. Henson, who, I'm not gonna lie, I wanted her to win. I love Taraji P. Henson. I've always loved Taraji P. Henson, even before Empire. I was a big fan. I think she's beautiful and talented and just really down to earth from what I gather. I wanted her to win. I thought that she was gonna win. I know that Empire is, to me, it's a guilty pleasure. It's a soap opera. Let's be honest, it's not the greatest show. But this past season really stepped up its game. And her character went through a lot of stuff, and she really, really advanced as an actress and a character in the second season of Empire. So I was really hoping she would win. Instead, they gave it to Tatiana Nazali for Orphan Black. Let me tell you something, I've never seen Orphan Black. I want to see it so bad. I know nothing about it, and that's the way I want it to stay until I sit down and watch it. All I know is that it has a sci-fi element, and that's enough. I'm sold. I have a few friends that love that show, and I'm so super glad that she won, because I know that series is coming to an end, if it hasn't already ended, and she's always nominated, she never gets the award. I'm glad she got the award. She seemed very happy and genuine about her win, so good for her. She's a very pretty actress, and I'm sure she's equally talented. Eventually, I will get around to watching that show, but good for her. Now, this made me so happy. Despite, again, not seeing the show, the actor category. The lead actor in the drama series, it went to Rami Malek for Mr. Robot. I've heard so much great things about this show. I have my friend, my dog is about to start his shit. I know it. Behave, Chucho. My friend, Movie Man Chad, he keeps saying, I will lend you season one. You've got to see this series. I'll see it, I swear. But I'm so happy for Rami Malek. He had outstanding competition. Kyle Chandler for Bloodline. They showed his reel, you know. I was impressed. I'm like, oh shit, I gotta see this show. Stop. Be nice. And by the way, Kovu is here as well. I'm sure you can see him in the frame. Stop it. I'm doing a video. I am entertaining somebody, or I'm at least making somebody go to sleep. Rami Malek is a very talented actor, and one thing I'm glad that he won for the fact that he's Egyptian. When's the last time an Egyptian actor won anything? And by the way, with his win and with all his credibility, please, if you're going to make a movie that takes place in Egypt, please cast him. Anyway, I'm so glad he won. His reaction was beautiful. He was so shocked and happy. I loved what he said. He's like, am I the only... Please tell me I'm not the only one seeing this. So happy for him. I'm happy because I can now say I've met two award-winning actors from the great film Short Term 12. Brie Larson, who's now an Oscar winner, and now Rami Malek, who's an Emmy winner. I met them both. I'm so happy. And I support this guy. And I cannot wait to watch this show. So then we move on to the final two categories. We have comedy series. That went to Veep. Veep. I mean, dude, is it really that good? God damn it. I mean, it was a long shot, but I was kind of hoping that Blackish was going to win. It would have been nice to see a network show win for once in the comedy category. And plus, I really like it. I love that show. But no. Veep, once again. Damn it. Why? Why? That show can't be stopped, man. So, you know, when the producer went up to accept the award, he was funny, but I would have given him props if he had just said, I already thanked everybody last year and the year before that. But whatever, you know, okay, I'll see it. I will see it. I said this last year, but yes, this year I will watch it, okay? Drama series. So happy. Game of Thrones is the winner of Outstanding Drama Series for the Emmys of 2016. So happy. Let me tell you why I'm happy. Last year, obviously I'm a fan, and it could have gone to any of... I thought it was going to go to Mr. Robot, honestly. Game of Thrones won last year for season 5. Understand that there was no bad season of Game of Thrones, but season 5 was definitely the weakest series. And I feel like the weakest season. All of a sudden, I am broken up with Storm. I apologize. It won for season 5. And I feel like it only won because Breaking Bad wasn't nominated. It was done. And that's the way it seems to go in these shows, you know? In these award shows. They win, because the best show is already, like, the previous show that won is off the air. That's I'm sorry to say this, but any comedy show is going to have to wait for Veep to end in order to become a winner. Game of Thrones Season 5 won. I was okay with it, but I didn't think it was a very good season. Season 6 was awesome. Awesome, awesome. It had some great episodes. That Battle of the Bastards episode, obviously, that was incredible. But the storytelling was great. Everything about it was terrific. So I'm glad that it won. It won for the right season. Thank you. Thank you very much. And that about does it. That about does it. I'm so glad that Game of Thrones won. There's definitely some people nominated that didn't win that I really wanted to see I wanted to see win. It didn't happen. But hey, you know, that doesn't change the way I feel about the shows. In fact, I said it before, half the shows that I watch aren't even nominated. So we are now 41 minutes into this goddamn video. I don't know what the hell happened and why time hates me, but I am gonna go ahead and go because you've already been. If somebody is watching this right now, I want you to leave a comment. Please, please, don't lie to me. But anyway, I've kept you guys here long enough. Thank you for whoever is actually watching. What? If you watched the show, are you disappointed with the winners? Who did you want to see win? Who are you glad to see that won? And, you know, all that shit, just comment down below. I'm gonna go now because I'm tired of hearing my own voice. So I can just imagine you're on the verge of shooting your brains out. Alright guys, peace out. Watch the show.